We're glad you're with us on this Wednesday edition of Take Five at the Journey. And I shared yesterday about how that Daniel was taken captive and how that he actually worked with people. You know, there was two things with Daniel. When we read the book of Daniel, they came in and stole the brain trust out of Israel. Nebuchadnezzar actually took these best ones out of the country. Let me read this to you, found in Daniel 1:3. And the king spake, Daniel 1:4, children whom there was no blemish, okay, well-favored, skillful in all wisdom, cunning in knowledge, they understanding science, and had such ability in them to stand in the king's palace, whom they may teach the learning and the tongue of the Chaldeans. So when Nebuchadnezzar came in, and he didn't take just average people. He took the brain trust, people that were well educated. So they took them in two ways. Number one, he took them into bondage. We understand bondage. Bondage is, how can I say this? If you're bound to alcohol, you're bound to drugs. We understand bondage in that way. But the second way the Bible describes that they were taken was by captivity. Captivity is where they tried to reprogram the mind. And Daniel, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, out of all the Israelis that were taken in, these guys stood up and they said, we will not be taken captive. We will not give in to the culture. You know, today there's so many Christians that's going along just to go along. And I'm saying this, we don't need to be mean-spirited. We don't need to be arrogant. But we as Christians need to learn, we don't need to be taken captivity by the world, the way the world thinks. We need to understand that we need to stay in thinking how God thinks. You know, they try to take them with bondage and they try to take them with captivity. They try to put them in chains. They try to do all those things in bondage, but then captivity is of the mind. And you know what? That's what the devil is trying to work on each and every day. He's trying to seize part of your thinking, trying to get you negative, trying to get you in the wrong thinking about things. And I tell you what, that's the play of the devil all the time. Breaking, getting a hold, and occupying your mind. That's why you need to read the Bible every day. That's why you need to understand the plan of the enemy is to take you captive. He tries to get at every one of your thoughts. Well, I love you. I want you to say to yourself this day that God is a good God and the devil's a bad devil.